So there are people who, for the lack of a better word, were not strong enough to cope with their depression. So for people who've been in their life, they look behind and they wonder what they could have done differently. And I know Alia struggles with that too, with you. Like, do you leave a person, or do you tread lightly? Are you meant to be intrusive? You don't know the right way. Is there, there's obviously not a blueprint, but is there something that you know for sure that people in your life can do, can't do, should do? For other people who have people in their lives who are going through depression, or people in their lives who have gone through depression and they don't know what they've done wrong?
Unfortunately, there is no one right answer, because everybody is different. There are, and it's also, everybody is different on a day-to-day basis. There are days I desperately want someone to talk to. There are days, if somebody asks me a question, it makes me feel worse. Having to answer, how are you feeling, makes me feel worse. There are, you know, it just varies from day to day. But I mean, this is something that I said earlier also. I think what really helps is to have someone to talk to who can contain what you have to say, who can tolerate what you have to say. I'm very lucky. I have friends that encourage me to talk to them, and their responses are always that of being able to contain what I have to say. They don't get overly flustered or emotional about it, and so as a result, I'm able to just be myself without the guilt of feeling like I'm making them feel bad or I'm making them worry. So I'm very lucky that I have that in my life. I have people that I can talk to quite easily. So I think the only thing, and that's also where my father helped me, which is he was the place where I went to who could tolerate. What, so if I say, Papa, I'm feeling like I don't want to be here anymore, he's like, yeah, beta, I understand, it's horrible, I've been there. It's not, oh my God, you know, oh my God, what are we going to do? He's sitting there and he's listening to me and he's saying, I get it. And as a result of that, I feel like I have somewhere where I can go, where it can be, where it's a safe space that somebody can hold it. So that's the only thing I feel has really helped me.
And I think it's important to face one thing, that only the courageous people have the ability to stay vulnerable. And when you're vulnerable, life touches you. You know, people who are egoistic are frightened of being vulnerable. That's why they create these defenses. I think that's what it's all about. And all great art, music, great writing. It's only when Shaheen got completely vulnerable, she could write like this. And you don't have answers. And the ability to listen. I think the most important thing what Shaheen said was about her friend, Namita, that she would just call up and she would cry. And then after half an hour, she said, are you done with crying? The very fact that somebody across the line listening to you as you cry.
So you don't really want answers.
There are no answers. There are pretenders who claim to have answers.
Papa.
And they institutionalize all those answers. And they impose those answers with the butt end of a gun. Or make it a religion. There are no answers.
I warned you, this is going to happen.
Mankind doesn't have answers. You bullshit to your children. You don't follow the things that you pretend to preach to them. They see it. I have never pretended to my children that I was in possession of the virtues that people flaunt. That's why they feel that they are not misfits with me. I am a misfit at 71. I can't expect a young little girl to fit into the sick world where brutality is legitimized.
Papa.
So nothing is wrong with you, darling. Nothing is wrong with you. The psychiatrist wants to fit you into this brutal world. He is more sick.
Papa. And small talk is for the small. So, for the very small. You don't have that chip, na? No. Okay, one more question. And Papa's not allowed to talk. You're not allowed to talk now. One more question, please. A nice question. No.
Now you want normal conversation.
Nobody wants to ask questions. It's great. Then we'll move on. We are very happy to. Okay, cool. Done. So now
I just want to congratulate you, you brave young woman, because I think the most important thing that Shaheen does, like somebody on my set the other day, I'm actually acting after I don't know how many years again, but came to me and they said, oh, your sister. And I presumed that they were going, about Alia. And they were like, no, your sister Shaheen is so courageous. I said, why? What happened? We saw her interview, and please thank her for normalizing what we try to gloss over all the time in this business that we are in. Everybody is depressed. She has had the courage to say that she is, and she's given everyone a signal that you're not alone.
Okay, before we exit, and Shaheen wants to say, you want to say something? We have to first launch the book. So you all launch the book. So this is the moment, guys. Penguin team on stage, please. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Video ke liye? Aap log pura dikhana, humne jo bhi baat kiya hai.